the second sword. Is it in case the first one breaks?
Just a dream. Wake up.
The doll. The attic.
All right. Time to check the attic.
Put it down, please. That's blood! Don't spill it! Please! Stop! Go away! Leave it!
Wait, the next room's blocked. Stuff. A doll. Drawing shows it lying in a cradle. Maybe I should find one. Another masterpiece. An oven and a blackened grate. Oh joy, a riddle. Guess I should find an oven.
Stop! Go away! Don't do that. Leave it!
Did I scare you? Scared you, didn't I? I could tell you were scared. Big brave man scared of wee little Sarah. Ain't that funny?
I wouldn't do that anymore if I were you, Sarah. You might scare someone so bad they'll hurt you.
Why would someone hurt me? Having a spot of fun's not allowed anymore.
What are you playing?
That lady fell asleep, and I've sent her some horrible dreams. I'm not her wake, neither. I can do that, you know. Funny, isn't it?
Very funny. Thing is, I gotta talk to the dreamer, so I'd like you to let her wake up.
Little Sarah doesn't want her to wake. Little Sarah wants to play.
You're lucky. I know you're a harmless godling, but others might not know, and then...
And how'd you know I'm a godling, eh? How's that, eh? Eh?
If it looks like one and acts like one, trust me, you're a godling. You give the dreamer nightmares and won't let her wake up. Why are you tormenting her?
I'm not tormenting anyone. Scary dreams are great. What I love is when this big hen chases me. Hen's got these red...
Why do you live in a haunted house?
Tell you a secret. The house ain't haunted. Not one bit. I just pretend it is. Make everyone think that. It was sitting there all empty. So I moved in. Bigwig from the bank then came and bought it. I don't like bankers, especially not to live with. So I decided to give him a scare.
Gave the banker a really big scare. See, he paid a lot for this house and won't give it up easily, which is why you need to find another home.
I don't want to! I don't! I won't!
Sarah, Novigrad's no place for a godling. But if you want to live here, that's your business. So let's make a deal.
A deal? What kind?
Leave the dreamer alone. In exchange, I'll tell the banker the house is haunted. For good, no way to lift the curse.
You tell him that? What if he doesn't believe you?
I'm a witcher. He'll believe me.
Yes, yes, yes! Do that, and I promise not to bother your friend. Not even a little. You're awfully nice, you know.
I don't hear that often. Thanks.
Now go wake that sleepyhead. I won't stop her. She'll get up.
Who are you?
Triss Merigold sent me to see you.
Gods. Horrible nightmares. I was supposed to dream the history of this house. Instead, I saw furniture. Hungry furniture that wished to devour me. I know it must sound foolish. But in the dream... well, it was all too real. And not at all amusing.
The work of a godling. She made people believe the house was haunted. also injected your dreams with her little jokes.
And you managed to wake me. I feel fortunate.
We witchers have our ways.
I thank you very much. The dreams, they were awful. Any way I can pay you back?
There is, actually. I'm looking for a young woman who was seen in Novigrad.
I can certainly try to help. But I'll need to clear my head first. After those deranged dreams, I feel it's full of cobwebs. Find me at the Golden Sturgeon. I rent a room there.
All right. See you there.
The second sword. I saw Miss Corrine leave, but she refused to speak to me. Is the matter resolved? Or quite the opposite?
A bit of both. A demon had captured Corrine. I managed to free her, but the house is still haunted.
Did Corrine dream of the building's past?
Yeah. Pretty horrid, apparently. Though she refused to talk about it. Nobody should inhabit the place.
So many crowns I paid! Oh, well. It shan't put me in the poorhouse. Truth is, Will.
Oh!
To seance like this before, let alone participated.
I will guide you. You must first achieve a kind of mental accord. I must ask some questions. You must answer them. It's important you're truthful. Answer from your heart.
Let's begin.
To start with, tell me a memory you have of this woman.
What for?
Do as I ask, please. I need the strongest, most complete memory you have of...
Ciri. The woman's name is Ciri. I accepted a job once. Did it. Asked to choose my reward, I invoked the law of surprise. Never thought I'd actually meet the child promised to me at that time. Years later, I was in the Broccolon Forest. Happened on a girl there. Didn't know who she was. The Dryads wanted to keep her, turn her into one of their own. But the Waters of Oblivion, they failed in her case. Ciri came out of Broccolon with me. I sent her back to her grandmother then. But already, I felt bound to her.
By destiny?
By something more.
Thank you. Would you be willing to share another memory?
Yes.
No need to rush.
Ciri was orphaned during the Second War with Nilfgaard. I had no idea what to do with a young girl. So I did what I would have done with a boy and took her to Kaer Morhen. Figured some physical training, sword work, development of her stamina, couldn't hurt. I remember her standing on a crumbling wall. A stone came loose, she lost her footing. Caught her at the last possible instant. Strongest memory, though, is of her coming out of her room one day. Wearing a dress and claiming she was indisposed. Knew then that Ciri was maturing. It was unavoidable. I was lost in the face of that.
I see. Do you wish to tell me anything more?
Yes.
In that case, I'm listening.
It was after her time training at Kaer Morhen. After the moment when Yennefer first called Ciri her daughter. We'd been separated. I knew she was in danger. I dreamt of her multiple times. I found her at Stega Castle. She'd gone there to free Yen and gotten herself captured in the process. They wanted to hurt her. I remember fighting side by side with Ciri on stairs slippery from blood. It was the first time she ever deflected a crossbow bolt with her sword. Told her never to try it again.
These memories, they're intense. Do you wish to continue?
I have more to say.
Then please do.
It was in Rivia. The second war with Nilfgaard had just ended. There was still tension in the air. For gods know what reason, race riots erupted in the town. I tried to do something, but couldn't stop a riled crowd. A boy with a pitchfork. He ran it right through my gut. Yennefer lay dying as well. Ciri had us carried onto a boat. We sailed to a place where apple trees bloom eternal. She left us there. That was the last time I saw her.
You claim the woman has abilities. Tell me about them.
She's a child of the Elder Blood.
A descendant of Bloody Falkir. The rebel burned at the stake. The prophecies claim the world's destroyer will be born of the Firebrand's cursed blood.
Pure legend.
No one a legend transforms into prophecy when it gains believers. I think you're right to be reticent in talking about the woman. I see. Do you wish to say more?
Yeah, there's something else. They call Ciri the Lady of Space and Time. Once I asked Yennefer why, she travels between worlds. Turns out I don't know how to talk about it. Didn't really understand much of what Yen told me. I just know there's more to it than traveling to different places, and that Ciri carries immense power in her blood.
I see. Do you wish to say more?
Yeah, there's... I remember Ciri having trouble controlling her abilities. Yennefer tried to teach her to cast simple spells, and Ciri destroyed a shed near the temple where they were. Really upset her, but it was just an old shed. I know it took her a while to gain control, and frankly, I doubt she controls her abilities fully to this day.
I see. Do you wish to say more?
No. Can we start?
Naturally. I knew you cared about her. But your tone, the emotions you so carefully conceal.
Let's continue, please.
Make yourself comfortable and try to relax. You must take my hand and talk of Ciri. Tell me where you think she might be. Who could be at her side?
If Ciri couldn't find me, I'm sure she would have looked for another friend.
Who do you mean?
Maybe Dandelion. They liked each other a lot.
Thank you.
Dreamt of a swallow at first. After that, just nightmares.
At times, the dreams can multiply. Show the past as well as the future.
The swallow. It symbolizes Ciri. She contacted Dandelion. I didn't know he was in town.
The poet. Heard about him. Someone left him the rosemary and thyme in their will.
Thanks for your help.
Good luck, Witcher. I hope you find your Ciri.
What are you doing, Rebel? Major, what are you doing, dog?
Don't know who you're looking for, but you won't.
Well, you're easy enough on the eye.
Never come back, you stinking spaddies!
All's we wanted was...
Next time I'll rip your fucking legs off and shove them up your ass till you've chose for teeth! In the nick of time, as always.
Zoltan, with your boot to someone's ass, as always. Who were those men?
Local color. I wasn't going more than a moment. Long enough for them to turn our home into theirs. All right, time for some spring cleaning. I've got to boot them all out. Care to join me?
With pleasure.
Greet each other like the gods ordained. Ages, pal.
Hey, Zoltan. You look good.
Training plenty lately. What with the war on, no Mahakaman need to be found, but Redanian lagers standing in just fine. You, though, you've withered a bit. Something worrying you?
It's about Ciri. I know she came to Novigrad. Might still be here.
You mean she's come back? I'll be damned. I wonder if I'd recognize her. How many years is it now? 6, 7? But what'd she be doing here?
Hiding, probably. She might be in danger.
See her in your dreams?
Couple times. Her and the Wild Hunt.
Oh, not good.
Not at all, but I know she came here and contacted Dandelion.
We've a wee problem, then.
Where's Dandelion?
I'd like to know that myself. Maybe he can explain what the hell's going on. I just failed to return, as you saw. Expecting to come home to your hot leg of boar and some cold ale? What do you find instead? A shite storm. Dandelion gone, the tavern chock full of bums. Have no clue what happened.
Let's look around. Might find something that'll put us...
Prime idea. I say we start on the ground floor. It's where he sat and wrote.
Annual balladry contest. Silver laurel awarded to Master Dandelion.
Prince Hereward himself did the honors. And the feast afterwards, to celebrate the laureates. Dandelion taught a swine to yodel, and I... another time.
Nose is too small.
Aye, and the sword's too big. By the by, is that how it's done? Killing a wyvern?
Technique's not quite right. But you gotta admit, he's doing it with gusto. From the finest vineyards, every last one.
No one knows the fruit of the vine like Dandelion.
This the loot he got from the elves of Dol Blathanna.
Aye. Must have been in a great rush to leave it behind.
The faculty of Oxenfurt University is honored to grant Julian Alfred Pancratz, Viscount de Letenove, the title of Master of the Seven Liberal Arts.
Keep forgetting he's got that damn fool name.
Ten barrels of Toussaint Dry, 5 cases of sodden triple mead. Nothing here.
No, that's exactly what we're looking for. It says planner.
Dandelion and planning, good one. Besides, anything he wrote here probably had a special system. Chaos only he could ever decipher. Actually, in the past, sometimes not even that.
Give him a chance. Might not be that bad. Seems when he inherited this fine establishment, it came with some fine responsibilities. Bookkeeping among them. He also made a habit of noting down the times of his meetings, official and private. So, who'd he been seeing of late? Here it is. Seems he's only been meeting women of late, the dog.
Not a bad idea. Dandelion's pretty loose-lipped.
That's what I'm counting on. We should divide these somehow. For that, I'll ask the lassies in my half, you interrogate the ones in yours. Should you?
Zoltan, wait.
And you figure that's unnatural because...
Wonderful. Meet me back here when you're done. Share our finding.
Right, you are. If you need anything, I'll be next door.
Hey.
I will give you the last copper. With interest. Give me a week, please.
Horson's no banker. He's an honest man. You pay on time, you get protection. You don't pay.
Help!
What you hollering for, stupid wench? What are you hoping for? A knight in shining armor?
Close enough.
Keep out of this, Greyhead. Not your concern.
Vespule has got someone else's protection now.
Really? Who's that be?
Mine. Offered her a better rate.
All right. So...
covered in blood, all of it. So much work for naught.
No need to thank me.
Sorry. Don't get me wrong, I'm...
Relax. It'll come out in the wash.
Of course it will. Just gotta soak it in white vinegar, but that's not my point. Junior shan't forgive me. Either I'll close up shop myself, or he'll...
Sorry. Didn't...
A woman's lot. Men have their fun, and we're stuck. Oh, well. I suppose I must move to Oxenfurt. Professors need clean undergarments.
Don't know if you remember.
I don't... Wait, I know you.
When you kicked Dandelion out, through the balcony. Actually, he's the reason I'm here. Know where he is?
Probably out whoring. That horse pheasant. That lying scoundrel.
Ouch. What did he do to get your goat?
Same thing as ever. Prize bullshitter came back, saying it was till death do we part this time. And no more than a week passed before I spotted him in Harborside, scrolling with some trollop on his arm. 'Twas the last straw. All those questions about the washerwomen at the bathhouse, then this. I beat him black and blue and threw him out on his...
This woman, he...
Claimed she was his niece from Covier. Corset so tight, her eyes...
Thanks for your help. Listen, when I find Dandelion, anything I should tell him?
No. I mean, tell him he's a two-faced snake, but...
I'm a friend of Dandelion's, looking for Elial.
You've come to the right spot. How might I be of service? Need something...
You, Elial?
Yes?
Sorry, I thought...
Oh, so it... Any better?
So you're...
Elial.
Did you and Dandelion?
I met him one night in a tavern.
Don't think I want to know what...
Oh, stop. He wasn't so drunk as not to figure it out. Besides, men don't interest me. I told him that from the start. Luckily, Dandelion's an open-minded fellow. We had a lovely evening. He became a loyal customer afterward.
Dandelion, did you shop often?
I tried many times.
When did you last see...
Some odd, as recorded.
What did...
If Dan... In...
Kalkstein...
You're too late, but as he...
Really?
Rad...
dive in and slip through the front as quick as a tomcat. Scramble out the hole in the back room.
This Baroness Lavalette's villa.
Shouldn't interest you. The Baroness don't mingle with just anyone.
Don't worry. I'm here to see your chambermaid, Molly.
Out of the way. Baroness is riding out. Be gone.
Geralt of Rivia at my doorstep. Surely this is no chance encounter.
Greetings, Baroness. Greetings, General. You're right. I'm here for a reason.
There's no mistaking you. But for etiquette's sake, Mary Louisa Lavalette, an Imperial General and a Witcher meet. And know each other. Surprising.
Yeah, we had an opportunity to, talk when the Emperor summoned me to Vizima.
Had you run afoul of Var Emrys? No. You'd be long dead if that were so. It seems, then, that you share some interest. But I shan't question you.
Looking for a girl named...
My maidservant. I'm afraid she's currently at the home of my dear...
Perhaps Geralt could accompany us.
Is that something you could...
Well, if...
Oh, no!
We've arrived.
My father owned a similar estate in Bruges. As a young girl, I'd travel there often to ride.
Shall we look at the horses? Do you like horses, Geralt?
I guess so. Called every horse I've had Roach.
The grey mare is Cantarella, sired by Cahir, the champion from Vol.
Grey's a nice color. For horses, too.
My coin's on the black stallion, Nemrod, purest Nilfgaardian stock.
Surprised he didn't salute you, General. Seem to know your horses.
No, is not the word. Morvran's a true expert.
I find them to be far more honest than men. Must say, I'm curious how you manage in the saddle, Witcher.
Mostly just try to stay in it.
What would you say to a little race?
Not what I came here for.
Don't make me beg, Witcher. Tell you what, win, and I shall give...
Why not?
Well said.
The grey mare looks nimble. Besides, you know a man named Cahir once. I'll go with her.
I'll not ride with you, but I shall bet on the steed. Nemrod.
In that case, I shall try my luck on the Zeracanian. I see no point in delaying.
Go to speed!
Fucking horses.
What a thrill! A beautiful victory!
Thanks.
For one for whom every horse is a roach, you carry yourself exquisitely in the saddle. My congratulations. That is yours.
Now, could I talk to your chambermaid, m'lady?
Ah, yes, Molly. That is why you came here, after all. The portly young woman. That's her.
Speak to her. And you must find us when you're ready to return to...
Sick of it all.
I'm Molly, my lord. Wish to see me?
Call me Geralt.
Geralt? That Geralt? The one Dandelion's rescued time and time again?
That's right. Except it's the other way around. I'm always saving him.
Mean to say it weren't Dandelion saved you in Flotsam by severing your noose with an arrow from 100 paces?
What? Dandelion couldn't... Never mind. Any idea where our master archer might be at the moment?
No. Sadly, I haven't got a clue. We've not seen each other in ages. The Baroness don't approve of our acquaintance. Says Dandelion's a good-for-nothing layabout. Can you imagine? But... or maybe his sister could help you. Such a nice girl.
Any chance you remember your last conversation with Dandelion?
Of course. He came to borrow some coin for a barge.
What? Why'd he need a barge?
To take me on a romantic cruise of the canals by the light of the moon. Said there'd be strawberries and that wine with the bubbles, and he'd sing me arias. But I've not seen him since.
You do realize Dandelion doesn't have a sister.
Sure he does. Saw him himself. Funny, she don't look like him at all. Blonde, for starters. Maybe they've different fathers.
Mm-hmm. Different mothers, too.
Maybe. But you could see he cares for her. Looks after her. The way he carried her packages and...
Know where I can find her, Dandelion's sister?
I know. Whenever I ask Dandelion when we visit her, he'd grow all quiet and then change the subject.
Thanks, Molly.
Wait. Before you go, I've got a request. Dandelion told me once he'd show me his etchings, but he never did. I'd so like to see him.
Won't be too hard to convince him. He loves showing off those etchings to anyone he can.
Oh, that's wonderful! Thanks, and good luck to you on your search.
Geralt, there you are. Shall we return together?
Gladly. It's a long way to Novigrad. Road ought to seem shorter with some company.
I'd say the same. Well then, let's go.
Thank you.
And here we are. Thank you for your company.
Likewise. See ya. Big changes afoot in the Empire.
You've no notion? The Emperor summoned you. He only ever summons with reason. It's clear he seeks his daughter.
You know a lot.
I must. I am my father's son.
What's your father got to do with this?
He is close to the Emperor. And knows the opposition. Knows they press for abdication. Ceding the throne to Cyrilla is the best the Emperor can do. But, as is known, an empress needs an emperor at her side. My father will ensure the...
Farewell.
What's he doing?
Excuse me. I'm looking for Marabella.
I am she. Wait outside. Class is in session.
I'll wait.
It won't take long. It turns out he'll not come up.
Now can we talk?
Yes.
I know you sod.
Oh, yes. Longest afternoon.
He read you his poem?
No. He perused the illustrated guide to fungi.
Maybe. No. Won't even try.
Mold. That was his... When his hand abandoned my knee to point at a figure of penicillium, I knew the fire between us had done.
See, Dandelion?
No. But he never came back.
Thanks for your help.